So you came together, yeah?
No. You came up, my husband first, and then after 6 months, my sister.
Did you tell me you were gonna be the only Filipino woman?
No. Didn't wanna scare her, did you?
You don't take Filipino, won't take Filipino.
Well, lots of Filipinos.
Yeah.
La mia gente.
Can you say lots? How many were there? Hundreds or?
Oh, I cannot tell you. Because, in fact, in the rain out, in, and then bunch of boys. And then I can't be married because I don't like, I have nobody else to talk with, if not me. How lucky, huh?
Where was the billiard parlor? Do you remember, was it Santa Rosa or Hillsburg or something?
Yeah, the billiard parlor.
The billiard?
Yeah, in Santa Rosa. And the woman thinks it's that last one.
Only men.
Only men. Only men.
And how long was it before?
No, they didn't have any more billiard parlors by the time I came.
What year was it?
1938.
Oh, I think it's 1938.
And how long was it before other Filipinos came?
Well, I don't remember how long now. Came there gradually, you know. I don't stay very long when they go there. Came to Sebastopol or Hillsburg or whatever.
How about your mom, Mary Ann? What year was that when she came?
1945. 1945. That's right now, Mary Ann.
Oh.
Mom, I think Betty talked to Mary.
Mary, yeah, a few years ago, yeah.
She must have been as well in the fish market. Was that nicer, that Japanese fish market? And went up to Mrs. Lidwell and said, are you Filipino?
Oh, yeah. Oh, really?
Yeah. So I was excited to see her.
Ms. Laverne, did I read that Mary is somewhere in New York now or somewhere?
No, Mary is working in our business department, but she wrote a book and was very successful.
Very good.
She got on television around the country. She wrote a book about savings and loans.
Oh, the big scam.
And that's what we made into a movie.
Yeah, how's your book? When is it going to come out so we can look for it?
I don't know.
You be sure and let us know.
I will next year.
Very good. Very good.
Okay, you said that your mother bumped into Mrs. Lidwell and Mrs. Lidwell.
What
market was that?
It's market down in Rubber
Street.
Rubber Street, I think.
Oh, yeah.
I remember that.
Ah.
That's right.
See? Got a lot of pioneers here. Hi, get a chair. Yeah, I was just going to say that probably from the Census Bureau.
I'm not sure what year it is.
1984. How much is that? We used to be in the other. We used to be in the other, yeah.
Mexican or, you know, Indian.
years.
Yeah, Gray's Brothers.
Well, these are all hops, right?
Hops. Hops, and some of them have Gray.
Busman's, that's right.
Not the.
Fever.
Yeah, and Busman Ranch.
Oh, that.
And they actually live in a farm labor house. And I have some pictures of some.
We have some of our.
Some of the people.
Much later. Pick up.
The, I have here, I find my old, my, I want to take a look at my mom and my dad. These are stories from our newspaper in the 1930s.
Oh, interesting.
About, prejudice against Filipinos.
Oh.
During the Depression, whenever white people were out work, then everybody hollered that the Filipinos were taking the junk on, passing it around.
Yeah.
And I'm sure, knowing how the newspaper was in the 1930s, and I'm saying this from experience, that these are greatly exaggerated, because they exaggerate this kind of thing. But you can see that there's stories here about apple wars and Filipinos and the labor problems.
When we acquired it?
Mm-hmm. 76. 76?
76.
Yeah.
Your population now, both elderly,
Oh, not the elderly, we're losing them all now.
More?
Yeah.
I mean, what kind of numbers are coming? What kind of Filipinos are being added to the county here? I mean, nothing like the Cambodians or nothing, the new wave of immigrants.
I think because of the laws and the immigration laws, we would have more Filipinos here than the ones that are.
We've got a quota.
There's a quota system, and all of us have relatives, I'm sure, I know I do, lots of relatives in Philippi that would want to come here, and we would love to have them here, but very difficult to come.
So it's very slow.
And mostly now, it seems to me, and
the younger group.
The professionals, and those are the ones that seem to get the visas, that can come in more than the agricultural ones.
They generally end up urban, don't they? They end up in the Bay Area, or the.
Rotor Car, yeah.
Petaluma, they have a good population now, and Americans going back to Philippines to get Filipino wife.
Oh, really? Okay.
They call the name Orton Brothers.
I'd like to make a comment about the community. I always thought there was some Filipino community before the actual organization of the community center, because even in the 40s, as long as I can remember, we always, on weekends, we'd gather at somebody's house, and any reason for a party, it could be a communion or a birthday or anything. The whole community would show up in different shifts all day long. That's the way that we can connect with one another. So that was the informal community gathering.
Do you think that by and large, Filipinos keep pretty much to their own community? Obviously, you don't, but the older ones, you think?
Yeah,
the older ones, yeah.
The older ones.
They used to.
Think it's a language thing?
I don't
speak it.
But normally.
I speak that a little bit.
I think it was a stress.
Well, part of it, I relate particularly with the older ones, that for so many years, we were confined. It wasn't by your choice.
Right.
You must have been experienced some kind of bitter thing.
Coming
from.
Well, I'll tell you, things aren't too light in my head.
Sammy, our former president.
Yeah, you gotta talk about like most of our pioneers here, they were treated pretty bad at that time. Well, it stays there.
It's like
what? It's just like what? It's possible doing on the Valentino ranch. And usually, that was the discrimination case. Tell them to get out of town or so. And then once also this Filipino, they reported such incidents, just quite a few incidents by then. And then they reported to the sheriff. And here the sheriff told them that, you don't want trouble, get out of town. Mm-hmm. And then that's their, reaction. So there's a lot of incidents here in this county. And so, but the most is in the Watsonville area.
Oh, really? Yeah. Watsonville is the famous one.
Yeah. Because at that time there were some lynching and stuff, And it happens, they have organizations there in the Filipinos. They call themselves the Yukonario. They protect themselves.
So they have actually militants.
Yeah. And so, they were stopped by the sheriff, by the highway patrol or the sheriff. So we have two bad experiences in the discrimination cases.
Tell me this. I know that being Portuguese myself, I am constantly mistaken for Italian. Filipinos, do people recognize you as Filipino? What are some of the things that you're mistaken for?
The Mexican? Chinese, Japanese, Hispanic, Alaska, Eskimo. But then it's like no
only when you're wearing fur.
A Mexican.
Filipino live by themselves.
So we get three kinds.
Yeah, there's Vietnamese in here, Japanese, one Filipino, and two Japanese kind.
That was before World War II, wasn't
that
it?
That was because, yeah,
asking about how the Japanese and the Filipinos get
the of course, after World War II began, the Japanese were taken away.
That's right.
Right.
Anybody else?
Yes. Actually, the first wave of Filipinos that came to the United States are the Sakata. They were contract workers that went to Hawaii. To work in the sugar plantation and pineapple. After three years contract, then they moved into the mainland here. Of course, Hawaii was still
territory
of the United States. Yeah. So they came here in 1929, and then they started all over California, and they followed the crops, of course, and they started like Watsonville and then all the way to Arizona or Delano. Also to Washington on the Yakima Valley. And here in Napa County, they work on the hops, and the sheep farm, and then the dryer, which is possible. So, and the second wave, of course, they came by their own. They came like in, let's say, 1928. So they paid so much money, like $96 one way on the ship. They were young, mostly
looking for opportunity.
Yeah. And then these Filipinos who came over, they are they're not educated at all. They are first grade, second grade, of course. But they are hardworking people, farmers.
Like the Mexican campus.
Yeah, it's not the
campus.
Like the Brazilian. That's when mostly all the pioneers here in San Rosa area came, Sakata, and then the second wave, and then the third wave.
Sakata is the first wave?
First wave.
Spell that.
That went to Hawaii and the sugar plantation.
Spell Sakata.
S-A-K-A. Yeah, they have a nice group that was written on the Sakata in Hawaii. It looks like it relates the experiences and discrimination of all the humans around here.
Americans in the Heart, when Carlos Ewell told me, his own personal journal, and it's in there, I wrote all the things down.
Of
everything available.
And the second way, now?
Like in
was there a name for these people?
No, they came by their own. See, at that time, it was still easy to get a visa to come over here. As long as you have the money to...
This was the 20s also?
Yeah, according to 28, 29.
And the others had gone early in the 20s to Hawaii.
Hawaii, yes. And after the contract that they came over.
Now, the young men who came like second wave, well, even first wave, how many of them stayed and how many went back, roughly? You think most stayed?
Yeah. Most of them stayed. There's only a few that went back.
Anybody else here besides Joe who came in that first wave?
I know Leo and Dali. Yeah, he worked in Big Island and then he came over around Leo and Dali.
Angel. Gan. Yeah, he's one of the oldest. He's the oldest and the
addressing, you know, what you said as an elder, the person you respect. So when Anilocano, you address them as mano and manang, like manang kiling, you address them as kiling. You always put the word mana, you respect them that they are elderly, you know. And mano is mano for male, yeah, male. Now, on another dialect again. Kuya and ate. You know, there's so many dialects there that
so many
Yeah, but the manong and the manang is mostly used because they're mostly all the pioneers are all
mostly
all the people they are in Ilocano. I-L-O-C-A-N-O.
Did any of the women work when they were, when the women's on Pierce Street. Did you work for him for quite a while? Or just off and on?
Just one thing you there. He must be a very influential person.
Oh, extremely.
To get the bride for Philippines.
Well, my father worked in the house for my chauffeur.
How many children do you have?
I have three. Two girls and one boy.
So how many years have you got?
Between the oldest one and me, she's 52 and I have 53.
I'm going to jail.
Big headlights, Filipino, all in jail.
gotcha, yeah.
Throwing blood on the front door and
right.
real.
Actually, that was the only recreation of the pioneers here in this county at that time, see, and
they play also another game that they like to play is a Chinese game, Pai Gao. Oh boy, that's a good.
Well, they have that in Rito now.
Yes.
Yeah. They've legalized
Mighty Domino.
With tiles.
Yeah, right, like the Domino tiles.
Good memories.
must have been mistaken as a Chinese, huh? Japanese.
What about during the war, when the Japanese were sent to camp? Did you get mistaken for Japanese and get some of the fallout? Because I know that in the first part of the war, the Chamber of Commerce here actually passed out ribbons and said, I am Chinese, so I am not Japanese, and gave them to the Chinese to wear so that people would appreciate Japanese. Well, I take the real ones for Russia.
Strong village.
I am a civil engineer. I work for a private consulting firm in San Jose.
Want to give a plug and tell me which one?
Oh, the name of the company?
Mm-hmm.
It's Morton Technologies.
Morton?
Morton Technologies.
That's the last wave now. An engineer.
That's the last wave.
The last wave.
When did you come to Sonoma County?
came here 1932, but I'm not stay here just in the summertime, then wintertime, I go to town.
Okay. What ranches did you work on in the summer? Where did you work here?
I work at Apple.
And in the winter you went south. How far south? All the way to Arizona?
You mean down south?
Mm-hmm. Where?
Guadalupe.
Oh, that's down right, yeah. And when did you come back to Sonoma County to stay?
We stayed in 1937.
1937. And did you work for one ranch after that?
No, we worked at bosses, almost every year they had to work in the other bosses, and then next year, then, yeah, not only one boss every year, no.
Now, you old-timers, is there anyone that you can remember, particularly ranchers or people and bosses that you work for, that you remember that was particularly nice to you, that was better to the Filipinos?
Well, they were very nice, but...
Nobody was very nice.
The prices of the contract, we are not working with the, by the hour.
You were a contractor. Yeah. Did any of you ever work for a man named Mills, Don Mills? Contractor?
Mills agency?
It's an old agency, and he brought me
for Cicero
again. Oh,
we were
John
Peterson.
Peterson in the hop ranch, yeah.
Yeah. And Ballard.
Ballard, yeah.
Lebron. Yeah, that's the one. And Sherry, that's the last, I think, that was one of them. Sherry, the last name.
Shelley?
Sherry, just like that.
Just like Sheriff?
Uh-huh.
Oh,
yeah.
Sheriff.
Yeah.
Right there. Well, he's a sheriff now, Sheriff.
Yeah, but they had bad luck in that time. It turned over really flat. All the happier that it started, all the better. When they restored the herb, it flooded, so they ruined all the happy rice.
Well, of course, the hops, for a time after the war, when the hops went away, they put the wrong kind of fertilizer and just wiped them out.
Yeah, we were still after the war.
Yeah.
I think I don't really remember when they quit farming with the hops. Yeah.
Did you do any other work after the hops?
After the hops, we go back to the apple.
To apple.
And then I go to Stockton with asparagus.
Oh, over in the valley. No real connection with grapes.
When I was working in Sonoma, I used to work, I started with the council in 1973. Mm-hmm. I used to go down to Sebastian, where I can find a lot of Filipinos.
So they were?
There were a lot.
Yeah.
They have their housing in one in that area. I can't remember what street it is. And the Maron Ranch, they have Filipinos in there.
Is there a Filipino community in Sonoma? I think
Yeah, but I remember, the owner, August, you know, every time they have the harvest, he would
come in with the wine, and he would ask the Filipinos to make toast and things, you know, the pichon. And we used to have parties there, and I used to play with this you know, that was early 70s, 74, 75. And he used to make a big thing.
He was a good guy.
He was a good guy with the Filipinos.
Yeah.
He really was.
Tell me how you spell your roast of pig.
Pichon. L-E-C-H-O-N. Yeah, he was really good to the Filipino guy. They're all gone now, they died. Then lately I heard that they're not even one worker there. I used to play cards with the son, you know, the guy who was done. And the whole family family, the whole family, his wife and me, it's all, once a year we have that.
What time of year?
On the month of May, June, you know, he would do it. And he would just come in with an overall with
four years. Guys!
We'll have to
turn
it
to
the
answer.
Yes,
we
have
it now.
Very nice man.
Okay, what have I forgotten before we look at pictures?
I can't think of any. Does anybody have anything they want to say now to share?
I should ask Mama Lucas.
Is that right?
Mama apt to, less comfortable, less apt to get out of your own community and into the, you know. Now we see Hispanics coming out and running for office and this kind of thing. Do you think that that'll ever happen with Filipinos here?
Well, we tried to fight during those days, and all we got was kicked in the teeth, spit on, among other things. We tried to fight.
Well, you know,
the more you fought, the more they beat you, the bloodier you got.
In the 50s, when we tried to buy property, we were denied. We were told authority to go, and we go back to the path by the same property, and we still have the for sale sign, but they knew you were Filipino. They didn't want you there. They wouldn't sell to you. But in the 60s, when these civil rights, yeah, and they came out with these the track notes over here on the Westgate,
mm-hmm.
Then it was different. But back then, you couldn't buy a house. You were lucky if you could get a chicken house. You know, a little bit of money. If you had the money, you just, they would have sold it.
One of my feelings, or theory anyway, is that anybody who goes to the Philippines, one of the first things they say about Filipinos is the incredible hospitality, that when you go to a Filipino house, you're made to feel at home and all attention is on you. And you're welcome in that house as if it's your own house, and made to feel very comfortable and always asked to come back to return to anything you may want, or even you may not want to even mention you like us because they may give it to you. So the cultural shock in that regard is coming again to another country and then not ever feeling welcomed or, you know, and I know that happens to practically every group, true, but I think because of that whole cultural shock, then it would cause you to withdraw.
It was more pronounced.
More pronounced, and so, I think then it was safer just to stay with one's own and embrace one's own, and that sort of just sort of stays and that don't make way. If you do, then like Norman was recalling an incident where in the Filipino housing at the end of the season, when you were to get their last paycheck, instead of getting their last paycheck, a bunch of men would come and start shooting at the housing, and so the Filipinos would have to gather and leave their belongings and just leave and get out of town.
Otherwise, this is about money.
Without their money.
Yeah, they hold in the back part of their pay, plus their last paycheck, and that would be it. They'd run.
The significance of all of this is that the Filipinos coming in now, or as the wave keeps coming in, is the thankfulness I feel that the pioneers they did the suffering, they laid the groundwork, they paid the dues, and now we can come in and others come in and just be professionals or whatever and sort of bring the fruits that were established by our elders. So I feel that we have a lot to be thankful for.
What about Philippine politics? Now, that's been a very volatile subject in the last 10 years, obviously. is there disagreement within, yeah, so this is something that you don't bring to the fiesta.
I don't have the politics of the fiesta. Everybody has their strong opinions about the politics of the
fiesta. I would like to mention, the year 1976, he's a senator now, he's presently a senator, he might just be running as a president. He came to work here in Sonoma County. His
oh,
name
really?
Is Senator John Osmeña.
John?
And he was on exile.
O-S-M-E-N-A.
M-E-N-A.
Where did he work here?
Yeah.
Where did
he work here as the CEO of People for Economic Opportunity.
Oh, no kidding.
And he was, well, I was a contact person. But he, there was an incident, that was the year that Marcos declared the martial law, 1972,
mm-hmm.
Okay, and he was involved in that Miranda incident. Good thing he was able to escape the country.
Uh-huh.
So the first job that he has was here in Sonoma County.
Oh, yes.
talked to him about a year and a half, and he said to me that, you know, when Mrs. Sloan called me up and said, Cora, I said, well, we just hired a Filipino guy. Would you know his name? Would you know him? He said, send it to the When he mentioned the name, right, by golly, I said, he's a household name. The father used to be the president of the Philippines.
Oh, really?
Romania.
Yeah.
Oh, yes, yeah. Romania.
John.
He's a senator now. Father.
Sergio.
Sergio.
Sergio. Sergio. Sergio. Sergio. Sergio. Sergio. Sergio. Sergio. Sergio. Sergio. Sergio.
Sergio. Sergio. Sergio. Sergio. Sergio. Sergio. Sergio. Sergio. Sergio. Sergio. Sergio. Sergio. Sergio. Sergio.
Sergio.
And he would never forget this town, Santa Rosa. When I met him, he said, I'll never forget this city of Santa Rosa because this is the first job I had when I was in exile.
You know, there's a very fancy Filipino lady, you know, here, Barbara Walter, you know Barbara?
Yes.
Yeah. She was married to
Santa Rosa or something. I don't know about that, but I know that he was married to the Walter.
The Barbara.
Yeah.
Fountain, old Fountain.
So I told her, invited
my daughter went to school with Kathy.
Walter. She was Kathy, yeah, with Kathy.
Yeah, who got, what a sad thing that was. Yeah, that was really tragic.
When I met him, Osmeña was asking me, said, do you still have this same Filipino center? You know, I brought him over to the basketball court. I said, you don't have dumpies? He said, no, we have a beautiful center. I said, one of these days, come down and see us.
Yeah, but limits, right?
Before the world,
Jack goes.